गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग प्रेम सूत्र, गुड मॉर्निंग ध्यान प्रीति, गुड मॉर्निंग ध्यान यात्री एंड ऑल दोज हु आर लिसनिंग टू मी। यू वांटेड मी टू स्पीक टू यू एक्सक्लूसिवली। इंडीड द बुद्धा एड्रेसेस द इंडिविजुअल इन यू एमिडस्ट द होल क्राउड। सच इज द कॉस्मिक नेचर ऑफ द मैसेज ऑफ अ बुद्धा। Indeed, he is like the picture of Mona Lisa hanging on the wall, and whosoever looks at the image, from whatever place or angle he is standing, will feel that Mona Lisa is smiling only at him. Such is the cosmic nature of the message of Buddha. It is meant for all. Though it may be addressed to a particular person. Therefore, when I decided to speak to you exclusively this morning, I was eagerly waiting for the morning to come. But existence always supports the Buddha if he has made any promise to anyone. So this is it. The morning we were waiting is finally here. I am ecstatic that I am speaking to my beloved one. I am nervous somewhat that I am speaking to you, not knowing what is going to happen. Maybe I am. Indeed, the Buddha trusts the existence. Existence supports a man of awakening every moment. The awaited morning is here in its full glory. You are here and I am too. No crowd, just you and me. Only openness, freedom and blissfulness. Then heart speaks to an enchanted heart beyond all dualities of body-mind realm. This is communion, the way of Buddhas. Just listen to me as if you are drowning in a fathomless abyss. Indeed, it will connect you to your being. Drop all barriers of body, mind and all dualities too. Hold this presence close to your heart. On the dumb bosom of this oblivious globe, although as unknown beings we seem to meet, indeed we are neither aliens nor as a stranger's joint. We are bound to each other by a causeless force beyond all human cognition. We are bound to each other by a causeless force beyond all human cognition. There is something within us that knows beyond all finite knowings. It is this knowing that we all are seeking. It is this knowing that we all are seeking. This is indeed the nature of enlightenment. This morning as I woke up, I found the aura of the rising sun to be apparently same. And it seemed the sun will rise the same way. The chirping of the birds and the rustling of the breeze across the Caribbean Ocean was all the way same. Yet still there is something new. The mind says everything is same old, not the being. For being, life is ever new, fresh and alive to each finite moment, eternity, each finite moment and alive to each finite moment. Eternity overflows through the finite moments. Only you have lost the contact. The sun is new, each day sun rises new with a different luster. The birds chirp to bring the message of the unknown, full of ecstasy. The breeze too is new and innocent. Do you know why? Because it is a new dawn at the horizon, and also a dawn of new awakening. Just you and I and bliss. A new surge of energy, a new silence surrounds, and in a moment I and you will be no more, just two beings will be overflowing, an aura of serenity ends. This is why this morning is so unique and blissful. Bring this serenity to your heart's content. Only this much I can say, and let the silence do the rest. For quite some time, I was meaning to talk to you, and I was looking for you all around. Like a shadow for lives, I have been following you, but you are always busy in this and that, and looking here and there, but you were never available to me. The essence of your being. Remember, I am the fragrance of your being. And it is only now that I got the opportunity. So let us go into an inner sojourn. Remember, your body is the visible soul, and soul is the invisible body. Body is manifest, and soul remains unmanifest beyond birth and death. Both body and soul are part of one synergistic harmony. Body comes into existence one day and will disappear too. The mind is subtler and lives on, but the being, the subtlest of all, is never born, never dies. Body and mind are part of one organic whole. Accept your body, love it. The harmony that body creates will certainly become door to meditation one day. Love your body, respect it, be grateful to it. Your body is the greatest miracle of the existence. Your body is the greatest miracle of the existence. It is the temple of the unknown. It is the most complex mechanism in the existence. It is not only unique, instead it is marvelous as well. And blessed are those who marvel. Blessed are those who marvel. Breathing is the alphabet of the body. And through breathing, you can easily be bridged to meditation. Only you have to be aware of it. Be simply it. No thinking is needed. No feeling is needed. Beyond the realm of feeling and thinking is the realm of meditation. Body feels, mind thinks. And be, just be. This is the ultimate experience of bliss. Beyond this, there is nothing. This is eternal search. You have arrived home. This is meditation. Mind wanders from where the healing and the process of transformation can really begin. Physical body is mere showcase. Definitely it cannot be the beginning. Can you start at bioplasmic level? Or you still have to go a step beyond? There are so many unresolved issues in each one of you that need to be addressed before the healing and the process of transformation can really begin. All issues are stored in the fathomless zero that occupied the world. The journey of healing has to begin from this point. Meditation, on the other hand, considers man himself as a disease that comes to man because of your inner imbalance between consciousness, ego, and mind, and then disappears. Therefore, meditation is the ultimate in healing. When you sit silently watching your breath, you are connected to the unconscious layers through the mind. You are connected to suppressed emotions, both at the personal and social level. Also, you are connected to the muscles and the physical system of karmas. Then you can clear out every knot, thus clearing the body of all karmas. So also is the process of transformation a continuum. For this, the seeker goes through various stages, as these stages lead into another. As one stage unfolds into another. It was the hour before God's awake, across the path of divine events, the huge foreboding mind of night, alone in our unlit temple of eternity. It was the hour before God's awake, across the path of divine events, the huge foreboding mind of night, alone in her temple of eternity. Alone in her temple of eternity, lay stressed immobile upon silence march. Almost one felt opaque, impenetrable, in the somber symbols of her eyeless muse. In the somber symbols of her eyeless muse, the abyss of the unbodied infinite, a fathomless zero occupied the world. Beloved friends, this is where the process of transformation begins. Master looks at your potentiality and gives you a name. Be it Prem Sutra, be it Dhyan Preeti or Dhyan Yatri. What is Dhyan? The English synonym meditation does not encompass all that Dhyan has within its womb. You are listening to me. The sound waves reach your eardrums. Maybe you may see the image, the form. What is that that gives you the cognition that the person that you are hearing and the person you are seeing is the same? All the sense organs carry the information. The eyes carry the form, the skin carry the touch, the eardrums carry the sound. All that is put into an empty space. Who coordinates all these impressions that come into the space? It is the Dhyan. It is a faculty beyond human cognition. It is faculty that is beyond all that is known, that coordinates, harmonizes, and sends the information to you. That faculty that harmonizes all that is diverse in you, all that is the outcome of sense functions, and therefore it brings harmony within you. Harmony within the functionings of the senses, and thus makes you one-pointed. You do not say that the person that you are seeing and the person that you are hearing are not one. You know it certainly, it is the same person that you are seeing and you are hearing. This is Dhyan. And what is love? Preeti means love. And there is another word, Pratiti, means when you become embodiment of something, then it becomes Pratiti. You become the embodiment of love. And what is the nature of love? It is an effortless, unseen but realized truth. It is unseen but realized. It speaks through silence, gestures, and pronounces aesthetic beauties. Indeed, it speaks through silence, gestures, and pronounces aesthetic beauties. It is an unseen but realized truth. The nature of love is spontaneous. When you have to make an effort to love someone, then it is not love. When love overflows spontaneously, then indeed you are tasting that which is emanating from deep within. Meera says, "Oh my beloved Krishna, what have you done to me? I do not have to make any effort to remember you. I just cannot forget you. There is no time that I do not remember you. When your countenance is not in front of me, when I am not overwhelmed by your presence, such is the nature of love. You are the potentiality of that. Let love and meditation merge into one another to create a synergistic harmony, to create a being, to create a Buddha good within you. Let it emerge from the deepest core of your being." And when you are Dhyan Yatri, a name given to you, it is that you are a traveler through the process of Dhyan. Every circumstance and situation that comes in life, or that life presence, you traverse it through, riding the wings of your awareness, riding the wings of Dhyan, the very essence of your being, the fragrance. Beloved friend, I love you. Love is my message. Love is my being. Love is the communion. Love is oneness. Love is harmony both within and without. Love is bliss. Let it be your message too. Love is my color and my climate as well. To me, love is the only religion. All else is just unnecessary and therefore can be discarded. All else is nothing but dreams, a mental game. Love is the only substantial thing in life. All else is illusion. Let love grow in you and then God will be growing on its own accord. If you miss love, you will miss God and all. Then life will be misery and despair. There is no way to God without love. There is nothing more sublime than love. God can be forgotten but not love. If love is remembered, God will happen as a consequence. It happens as a consequence always. God is the fragrance of love and nothing else. In fact, there is no God but only godliness. There is no person like God anywhere. Drop all childish attitudes. Never go on searching for a father. Divineness is, God is not. Entire cosmos is permeated by our expanding consciousness that is referred to as God. It is your realization now. And once you have realized this, you can enjoy the fruits of the entire cosmos. Then the entire cosmos belongs to you and you belong to the whole. Such is the essence of spiritual life. Therefore, for that right question and understanding, you have to prepare the soil of your awareness. If you are not in love, then what to say about God? Even you are not. I was thinking, what should I give to you today? Because it is the dawn of a new awakening. I can share with you my love, my awareness, and my understanding now and ever. This day, absolute consciousness incarnated as Christ, as Krishna. This is the day when absolute consciousness saw the first time the green of the trees and the blue of the skies. This was the day when for the first time consciousness opened its eyes and saw God all around. Of course, the word God did not exist at that moment. However, all that it saw was God. That is what I mean by love, a union. Because in union, those who join together remain separate from the rest. In unity, they dissolve, they melt into one another, they become one. And that moment, I call the moment of truth. When love has given you unity and oneness too. First, love gives you unity in your innermost core. Then you are no more body, no more mind, and no more soul. You are simply one, unnamed, undefined, unclassified, no more determinate, definable, no more comprehensible, a mystery, a joy, a surprise, jubilation, and a great celebration. First, love gives you an inner unity. This is fana, as Sufis call this happening. And when the inner unity has happened, the second happens on its own. You are not to do anything for it. Then you start falling in unity with the world beyond you. Then the drop disappears in the ocean, and ocean disappears into the drop. Then the drop disappears in the ocean, and the ocean disappears into the drop. That moment of orgasm between you and the whole is where you become one. That moment of orgasm where you and the whole is where you experience your inner nature, the Buddha. That moment is the moment Buddhahood is imparted to you. This is enlightenment. Love is the way. Love is the way of preparing the soil of your heart. If you are full of love, the world is full of God. They go parallel. They are part of one symphony. It is like the sympathetic strings of sitar that automatically begins to echo the moment the sitarist plays the strings, begins to vibrate the strings. God is the echo from the universe. When you are in love, the echo is there. When you are not in love, how can there be an echo? God is an echo that lingers in your heart, like the dissolving notes of a melody that you have once heard in the wilderness. God is an echo that lingers in your heart, like the dissolving notes of a melody that you have once heard in the wilderness. It is only you who are reflected again and again in millions of ways. It is you who are thrown back to yourself again and again. If you are in love, God is. I was thinking, what should I give to you today as my gift? Then I remembered the saying of Buddha, gift of truth excels all other gifts. And my truth is love. Truth is solitary. Truth is love. And that is all you need to discover deep within. And it is significant to this day, because today is the full moon day, when in the month of May, Buddha was born. Buddha attained enlightenment 40 years later. And again 40 years later, At the age of 80, Buddha attained to Mahaparinirvana at the triple anniversary. The word truth looks to me a little too dry and desert-like. I am not in much tune with the word truth. It looks too logical. It looks too prosaic as well. It gives you the feeling of philosophy, not of religion. It gives you the idea as if you have concluded. You have come to a conclusion. And there has been a syllogism behind it, argumentation, logic and reason. Instead of truth, love is my word. Love is of the heart. Truth is partial. Only your head is involved in truth. In love, you are involved as totality. Your body, your mind, your soul, all is involved. Love makes you a unity, but not a union. Remember, love is unity, and my word is love, unity, a harmony, oneness. So I, my beloved one, I love you, and I would like you to fill the whole world with love. Let that be your religion. Love is simply love. In love you can be a Christ. In love you can be a Buddha. In love you can be a Krishna. But there is no Buddhist love and there is no Christian love. In love you disappear. You disappear as body. You disappear as mind. In love you come to an utter relaxation. I call you a Buddha. Yes, indeed you are that. And I speak to you of Buddhas because they have come to know a different space within themselves. A space which cannot be confined by the mind and which cannot be defined as part of the functioning of the mind. That silent space when thoughts are no more, no ripples arise. This is the beginning of the philosophy of Buddhas. This is the realm to which Master belongs. To this realm I want to take to you. Indeed, this is just the beginning. This is my message as gift to you, the celebration of enlightenment as the ultimate flowering of your being, now and ever and anon. Each moment a circumstance comes, and situation too. Make it your meditation, make it your dhyan, make it your awareness. Love will happen on its own. Then meditation becomes the ultimate in healing, ultimate in the process of transformation. Continue each moment in each situation full of awareness, full of dhyana. And then repeat to sustain the inner state of awareness. Life will undergo the process of transformation. Allow the journey to continue. Then one day suddenly something happens. At this stage all efforts cease and you reach to the realm of effortlessness. The journey from effort to effortlessness is the only journey, the only yatra. And you are the traveler along that path. Journey from effort to effortlessness. Life is synergistic harmony. Each moment, each action and everything unfolds into the other, thus creating a chain link. Dhyan is the string that weaves all the actions, all the moments that life presents to you like precious jewels. Dhyan is the invisible string that passes through all these precious jewels, the moments, the actions, and every circumstance that life unfolds for you. Each moment something dissolves into the dark cave from one end. The day merges into the night. Night comes with dark cave. Then as night continues its journey, the dawn, the sunrise, the light comes in. Night unfolds into the day. Day unfolds, dissolves itself into the night. The process goes on. And the next moment, from the other end, evolves as something new and resurrected. This is life and its process. The day dissolves into night. When night dissolves into the day, you are resurrected, born afresh, new, a new dawn, a new day, a new beginning. You are never in harmony with all that is or is happening. Misery is the outcome. To flow with life is the secret of a spiritual life. The day you decide not to ask for things that you like, rather to like things that happen, that day you become mature. You can lifelong keep wanting and seeking what you like through various means, prayers and others. This is what is happening. All your prayers, rituals are to fulfill your numerous desires. However, these keep you always miserable. Remember, the life and the world does not run according to your likes and dislikes. There is no guarantee that what you want, life also wants that for you. And the gap between the two is the measure of your misery and the state of inner growth. There is no guarantee. There is every possibility that life is destined towards something that you do not know anything about at all. Life takes you towards the unknown and unknowable. Life wants you to trust all that is unknown and unknowable. Life wants you to move from the dimension of the known to unknown. Life wants you to move from the dimension of the known to the unknown. However, the mind seeks and hankers for all that is known. Everything in this world that really happens is guided by a certain principle. You can call it by any name. However, no name can encompass the magnanimity of it, and you are never in harmony with this. Sometimes when the things that you like does happen, you will still not feel very happy. This happens quite naturally. It is so because whatever we demand, we have already lived in fantasy of it, so it is always second hand. If you say that you would like a certain person to be your lover, then in many dreams and in many fantasies, you have already loved that person. And if it happens, then the real person is going to fall short of your fantasy. The person is going to be just a carbon copy, because reality is never as fantastic as fantasy. Then you will be frustrated. So is the case with all your dreams and dream house. All the while you have been dreaming this house, in fact you have lived in that house through your fantasy. And when you really get the house, it will fall short of your expectations, and you will remain miserable even after you get your dream house. But if you start liking and be in harmony with all that is happening moment to moment, if you do not impose your own will against that of the whole, If you simply are in harmony with all that happens, you simply say yes, then you can never be miserable. Because then no matter what happens, you are always in positive attitude, ready to receive it. Because then no matter what happens, you are always in positive attitude, ready to receive it and enjoy all that existence wants to bestow on you. You wanted me. You wanted me to speak to you and you alone. So I have done it. And this is it for now. And this is it for now. Take care. Take care. Only this much for now.